Hey everybody, happy Sunday. You know what, I'm getting the building clean here in front, power wash. So it's about time. But now you want to look for the store, just look for the clean spot, all right? So these guys are great. Hey, he told me he'd be here at 8:30, and I got here at 8:30, and he was already halfway done. That's pretty cool. You don't see that too often around here. But I'm gonna take you in the store. I got a lot of new products to show you around a little bit. And we got some good stuff going on here, plus a clean storefront. And one reason I want to do this right now is I've got a sign coming, a new sign, because you know people say they can't find the store. I don't know why. So I got an 8-foot lit up sign that's over the doors there. It should be another, a week or two, supposedly. So no excuses after that. I told the guy building it, I said I want the people up in the space station to see it. So this thing's going to be big and bright.
That's going to be awesome.
Well, let's go in the store. I'll show you around. So we've got a line winder here now so we can spool up your reels for you. We've got a lot of P-line in stock, and I've got the other types of line coming. So no problem at all. Just bring your reel in here and we'll spool you up. Now, I've got a deal going for a while anyway with any Daiwa reel. Not on the combos, but the, like a Lexus and the spinning reels. You buy a new Daiwa reel here and I'll spool it up for you at no extra charge of any of these lines you've got here. And then I've also got some Abu reels here I want to show you. You don't get free line with these, but these are really good reels I'm going to show you. So this is the Abu Garcia Ambassador, the old Ambassadors, but with line counters got now. And I really like them. What's kind of cool is the displays on them. These are a digital display. They're backlit really well, and the numbers are really big, so people like me can see them. And they seem to be very good quality, and they're only like $82, I think. So you can't beat that. I think these are real good quality reel. I've been using Ambassadors since it was the very first reel I ever bought was an Ambassador, just like this, without the line counter on it. But I like these line counters, and we've got some, without the line counters too. So for $82, you cannot beat the old Abu Garcia here with the line counter on it. And then we've also got plenty of Lexus, and then the higher end line counters and other reels. In fact, I've got a big order I just found out from Daiwa that's coming in, so I'm going to be really well stocked with real high quality reels by, I would think, the end of this week probably. I also have got a lot of Procure in stock, all different kinds. Got all your Kokanee stuff, and plus the Rooster Tail scent spray here, which is a Yakima product, but of course Procure makes it. And everything you need for brining and dyeing your baits, and of course all the super gels and sauces and oils and my stuff here, Scent Chamber Magic. That's the best. But this is a pretty good collection of Procure, and it keeps growing. We'll keep getting it all till there's not more to get. Quite a few guys have asked me about garlic incense. Sometimes with the springers, when the water warms up a little bit, the garlic is a really big deal. So you can, just like this super sauce garlic, nothing wrong with that, but some people might not realize that Salmon Slammer, the oil and the gel, this has got a lot of garlic in it. So this time of year, well, in the fall too, but right now if you're looking for something and you want a little bit of garlic, the Salmon Slammer is a good way to go. Always had really good luck with that one. I know that's Phil Perrone, who owns Procure, right? He always says that's his favorite scent. We've done really well with it. I've got a really big selection of Smile Blades. Got some good Hoochies. The little individual blades if you want to build your own stuff. Beads and components. I've got some salmon nets still in stock. I think that's all for the salmon nets. I'll get more eventually. And I do have more of the kokanee nets. I've got more than just two in the back here. So you need a good kokanee net. And these Beckman nets, I've looked around different kinds of nets and see if there's something else that maybe I should be carrying in here. I don't think so. These kokanee nets are great. A lot of Yamamoto stuff. A lot more people bass fishing, which is pretty cool. Been selling a lot of Yamamoto products lately. We've got the cowboys and all the newer baits, but then your basic ones, the Senkos. Got a bunch of Senkos over here. Got swim Senkos. Oh man, I'm getting wiped out on swim Senkos. So, got to get an order in for some of that. But a lot of the grubs, hula grubs, fish in the Columbia River for smallmouth, and get yourself some hula grubs. And the D-shads with those twist lock, those owner twist lock hooks that Yamamoto helped them develop. It's got the weight in them. Those things are just perfect. It's a great way to go. And of course, you guys down in California got the predator minnows here from P-Line. You're trolling for stripers and the tails to go on them from P-Line. Real good tails, super tough. You know, you can catch a lot of fish with them. And the P-Line jigs, you can do some jigging down there. And of course, all the P-Line, and I just got in the topwater line. This new line they've developed just for topwater. So if you're frog fishing or popping, real good quality line for that. Might give it a try. And then of course the braid. Oh, we're looking for Dacron leader. Got that in here finally from Brad's. Good Dacron leader, reasonable price. The spinning glows. We actually have a few spinning glows now. This wasn't really hard to get. Got the power bait, a whole bunch of thirsty beads. We just got restocked on thirsty beads and the BNR beads. So that's a good thing to buy ahead of time, because you know, when the steelheads start up again here in the summer or later on, and like, oh, I want this color. Well, at that time, that color might not be available. You know, people buy everything at once. So that's a good kind of a thing, just to stock up on ahead of time a little bit. And then you all get you guys that still like hard beads, I got the Brad's. There's some guys that just will not fish anything but these Brad's hard beads. It's old fashioned, good stuff. And the BNR Holy Worms, got those. The Spro plugs, these are catching fish. And the Spro jigs, Rockstar jigs. Got the walleye been eating up these Mad Eye minnows. Really good. This is probably my favorite, but who cares what I think, but those have been catching some fish. And if you guys are chasing smallmouth, highly recommend you try one of these spay baits from Spro. These are fun too, the spin johns they're called. And these are really fun to fish. It's like an underwater prop bait, underwater. It's like a topwater bait, but you fish it underwater. And the smallmouth just tear these things up. This little purple color here is really good. And then, of course, more of the Spro stuff. Into bass fishing, got the frogs. All kinds of crankbaits from Spro, all good quality. And over here, of course, got all the Max stuff. I got more Max stuff than anybody in the world. According to Max, any single store anyway, you know. And little flashers, got quick releases here, Good Day Fishing quick releases. And the cable leaders, stainless steel cable leaders, bumpers for trolling. Double D Dodgers, sling blades, got the Max inline triangle flashers and the Max paddle UV paddle flashers that you put scent in. I like those. They have a lot of power. You can fish a little bigger lure behind them, and they're really get it whipped around good. And then of course all the Yakima fish flash and the spin doctors. There's a few guys out there that know about these, you know, and they really do well with them. They're a good deal. Just another 360 style rotating flasher. Got stocked up on fish field floats. I got a bunch of other floats. Got the bubble floats in here now. These are all new for casting flies or little lures. I got some arrow floats in here now. Some fixed floats. You want to fish a fixed float, there you go. And then the Good Day Fishing eye catchers. You know, you want to dress up your lures. This is where I just heard from Brad's that the Dodgers are back in, the Kokanee Dodgers, the Brad's Extreme Kokanee Dodgers. So by the next day or two, hopefully we'll be stocked up again on these Brad's Dodgers. Wobbler floats, you're gonna start, you know, anchoring up for salmon. We got the floats for you here. A ghost thread, don't leave home without that. That's really good stuff. Got a little wiped out on the wigglers. Hope we can get those restocked here pretty quick. Got some divers in here for you, the Tripsy divers. He's come from the East Coast. He's good quality divers. And, oh, mag lips. We got some mag lips. Try to get restocked on those. This is what's left of my spinfish. I've actually gotten quite a few spinfish in lately, and they just sell right away. It's crazy. I got in 24 dozen a few weeks ago, and in one day, I sold over 23 dozen. That's just insane. But, you know, this is all I got left right now. Hopefully more are coming. And plenty of killer fish. You guys going out for rockfish, you can't beat these fish field tails here. Super tough. You can catch a lot of fish on each one. They work really well. I'll show you my favorite color if you want to know. Everybody's always asking me what I like. There's only this is what I like right here. Not that others won't work, but this Ling Candy, it's called. This one I've done really well with. But, you know, also the Slate A I tend to use. Red Tail Wrecker, I like that contrast. Yeah, sometimes it really doesn't matter. But sometimes color does seem to matter, but I like this color a lot. I got a whole nother bag here. Good deal. Must have got stocked up on those. Got plenty of Oregon Tackle lead. There you go, you want some lead. And we got, you know, egg weights. And, got stuff in here too. Oh, get little jig heads in the drawers here. So you can kind of look in here in the drawers. But we got stocked up pretty good on lead. And all the Oregon Tackle, Unibobbers. These, fish fields got these. If you're casting lures or you want a banana weight for trolling, but casting too, you know, banana weights like this are good for casting also. But fish fields got these where they've got a chain swivel, you know, tornado chain swivel built into the thing itself. So it's perfect for casting, especially if you're doing that or trolling. But these are really good for that. You can see the chain swivel there. Good stuff. Yeah, bullet weights and some Brad's hooks. You know, you want a deal on hooks, there you go. You can't get any cheaper than that. But it's funny, you know, some people won't use them at all, and other people swear by them. They're like, they gotta have those hooks. And I don't know, whatever. Then I got the Gamagatsu hooks. You want some good hooks? And all kinds of different, all the Invisa swivels, and, you know, I've got all the basic stuff here. So a lot of these tornado chain swivels just on their own, really good for trolling. The more swivels you have out there, if you're using a 360 flash or something like that, and you really want to have all the swivels you can with those things. I got some inexpensive swivels and things here, and then the Spro, the better stuff, a little more expensive, but real high quality. But really stocked up good on the cushets. Been selling a lot of cushets. And the net floats, getting a little low on those. Those are becoming popular. People are figuring out about the old, you know, you put these on your net. And not only will it float your net if you drop your net, but also you net that fish and bring it up against the boat. This protects your boat from getting scratched from your net. And then from the rivers here, you know, you slam that net down the bottom of your boat, you're just spooking all the fish in that area. So that's what something that Jason Hambly pointed out to me. You know, he's got this on his net. He goes, I like the way it dampens the sound. People are dropping that net on the floor of the boat. So good stuff there. If you're rock fishing, like the show that was on this weekend, we did really well with the P-line twin tail squid here for ling cod and yellowtail rockfish sort of thing. These things really do fish well, and they're tough. They catch a lot of fish with each one. That's a big deal, I think. And then I've got some good camping stuff here. You're getting ready to do some camping. It's a real high quality sleeping bags and pads and different pillows and things. And then we've got some Fishaholic stuff here. If you want an inexpensive drive bag, there you go. It's pretty cool. And another bag that it's a backpack and dry bag. That's a good one. Some shirts, and I got some ProCare sweatshirts in here now if you want some sweatshirts. Oh, and these glasses. I just sold a ton of these Fishaholic sunglasses, you know, cheap sunglasses, 20 bucks, but real good quality. I'm selling a lot of those. Got getting wiped out on some books here, but books here seems like getting more popular. I'm selling a lot of books. from STS or Precmoto Publications. Got a few Daiwa reels here. Some real good quality spinning reels, you know, salmon or steelhead more, but bass, walleye, looking for a good quality reel. There you go. And then some line counter Lexes. And I've got a big order, like I was saying, I got a big Daiwa order coming in. So I'm gonna have a lot of good reels, you know, more of them, a lot of them coming real soon. Well, these, Chris's mother, you know, Chrissa that works here, her mother, Kyra, she works here also, but she makes these. And been actually been selling quite a few of them. You know, you gotta take care of your wife and your girlfriend in here shopping, right? And bait, I'm getting low on worms. Gotta put in a worm order. Got the good ProCure eggs. Yeah, these, boy, it's been, I just got these in maybe a week or so ago and sold a lot, so that's good. And I've got anchovies, herring, and just about every size except green label. Sorry about that, just can't get it. Tons of Washington coon shrimp, although I'm getting low now. I got to put another order. Sold a lot of coon shrimp lately. Coon shrimp's been working really well, and that Washington coon shrimp is the best stuff, no doubt about it. So this I just got in. These are Trinidad anchovy bait heads. So a lot of guys fishing anchovies now, more than usual probably, because you can't get that green label herring. And anchovies do work. I know several guides around here that do really well, and even if there was green label herring available, they'd still be fishing anchovies because they think they fish better. So, you know, it's just whatever you think. But these are some great heads for fishing anchovies or anything where you want to use the whole head. This isn't a cut plug thing. This is to shove that whole anchovy up in there, and then you got the wire that goes down in the body, and you can bend that wire and get whatever shape you want, whatever spin you want on your anchovy. These are very popular. A good product, I think. I just got them in. The anchovy classic bait heads are on the website. The purple haze color here is the most popular, although I don't think there's anything wrong with the chartreuse. And then there is a chrome that's interesting. So we've got some of the Dixure spins too, and of course bait buttons and clear boards and these pro releases. You need some releases for your downriggers. I highly recommend these pro releases. They're great for kokanee or even, you know, fishing deep in the ocean for salmon. And the little Cleos and Castmasters and Rooster Tails. And oh, here's my trolling flies. I sold a ton of these trolling flies lately, which is cool. Trolling flies are fun to fish. And then now, you got the micro kokanee fly, Arctic Fox micro kokanee flies. And these things, I think, are just fantastic. They put the, when they were first showed me these, they had treble hooks on them. I was like, no, I don't want treble hooks. So I suggested how to rig them, and they did. So these I think are really good. Just a real small kokanee trolling fly. And also then, you know, you're catching all those fish. These pro fillet mats, can't beat these, and the boards. I've got quite a few mats in stock and boards, and we should have a steady supply of those, but they've been selling really well. And these mats are just fantastic. They are, you know, good quality, good deal. You can, you know, clean your tailgate or when you're on a, you know, in a public cleaning facility of some sort, and you know, those things are kind of nasty. And so then you got a nice mat to play your fish on and also keep your meat clean. I think I always get kind of grossed out by those public, you know, cleaning tables. The Pro-Troll Prop Savers, get the line out of your prop. And, you know, of course, hitting the rocks too, but, you know, I almost think for a lot of guys, the idea that this will keep the line out of your prop is probably more valuable than, you know, keeping your prop from hitting the rocks, because a lot of guys aren't that close to the rocks. But a good idea to have that on your motor. And I got all the bags here from Fishfield and lead. You guys are doing some crabbing. You know, I see people try to do all kinds of crazy things to put weight on their ropes. We'll just get a weighted rope. This is lead core rope. They're $19.99. Super simple. just, you don't have to mess around. You're not going to have floating ropes or tying lead onto your ropes or whatever, all crazy things I've seen. And we got that and some good floats here. Everything you need. Bait bags. Super simple bait bags. Good quality for your crab traps. So, it's all good. We've got a lot of stuff in here. A lot of new stuff coming soon. And we're going to have rods soon. I mean, some really good rods. 100% made here in Woodland, Washington. And I'll probably be able to show you at least some of those starting next week. So, take care and hope you're getting some fish. Yeah.